Hey guys, just watching the birds. Love flying. Race been canceled due to weather, so I'm just love flying the birds. But they've been flying for 3 hours. I mean, I kid you not, 3 hours straight. I've been watching them. You know, they ranged out, and then they, they've been flying around the loft for about an hour. So, but they disappeared for a couple hours. But anyways, not sure what, maybe, I'm sure it's because I prepped them for racing and, you know, and since we're not racing, I just let them out and so they, I don't know if they just have so much energy from all that preparation, you know, the feeding and whatever. So yeah, they, as you can see, they've been flying for 3 hours. Anyways, just waiting for it to come, for them to come home or come in the loft, so I can go in the house and eat breakfast. I really like to be out here when they come in, partly because hopefully it's a deterrent, hawk deterrent. You know, having a human standing by a loft. Oh, here we go. Coming in. All right, so they're getting better about not landing on the roof. You got a few more up there that just stubborn. I better put a few more flags up there, but there we go. But yeah, they're definitely getting better. It's so hard for them to all land on the platform when they're all together. I on race day, I'm hoping that, you know, they're gonna bypass the roof and just go straight into the trap. So, you know, that's one thing I learned about, well, I've always known that. It's just that I, like I said, I've been so busy that I never got the chance to really get the loft completely done before the race season started. As you can see, even on the roof there, I mean, that's the best I could think of, is to put little flags up there, which is kind of helping. And then, you know, of course I got the fencing too, but the little flag was like my hurry up and, you know, come up with something. So it's helpful. You know, I don't really know if there is a 100% way of, you know, other than, you know, training them from the beginning. But again, kind of late in the game for that. So, so yeah, that's the best thing I could come up with for now. Anyway, let's take a look at the birds. Like I said, they've been flying for 3 hours, so. And, their feed ready for them since we're not racing this weekend. I brought them back down to a low diet, I don't know, kind of food. So let's put this drink here. Yeah, they're looking good. Looking really good. As you can see, I don't have as many birds as I used to. There used to be 80 pigeons in here. But, you know, some of them died from that virus. If you look at my old videos, had a virus, you know, birds were throwing up and die within 12 to 24 hours. So, they're a little thirsty. Been flying for 3 hours. Yeah, they look really good. Look at that. They're not even like, not panting or anything. But you know, at this point, they shouldn't be, because they've had three raises already. So yeah, they're in very good condition at this point. You know, some of them, I have no doubt, have you know, they're like damaged, right? Damaged goods from the sickness. So they've never flown the same since they got sick. And then some recovered probably almost 100%. But, you know, lesson learned. I don't know if you can necessarily prevent those young bird sickness. You know, I've never had them before, so, you know, this year is the first time I've had a disease or sickness. So, but these guys are looking really good right now, so I come in here once in a while and hold one of them and just handle one of them and make sure they're not too fat, you know. And I carefully measure what they eat. And there's room for improvement, obviously, but we'll see. My birds generally don't perform well until the longer races. You know, from 270 upwards, that's when I notice they start to make it to the 10% at least. But, which reminds me, last race we had, our birds were right in there. I think we took third place in one of the races. If you look at the on the national database, I am technically not in the race. You know, Ponderosa lost. It's not technically in the race. I gave all my birds to my wife. Her loft name is Seabreeze Loft. So if you look at the, I know some of you look at the national database of the ARPU site, you're not gonna find Ponderosa Loft this year because I'm technically not racing and I gave all my birds to my wife. So if you want to see our results, it's going to be under Seabreeze Law. These are the two Jansen babies. Brian Lewis's, Uncle Brian Lewis's breeders. You can kind of tell they're kind of built the same, they have the same waddle. And even the way they stand, it's kind of cute. They're like twins, except the other one's hide and the other one is straight rhubarb. Wanted to give you guys some updates on birds and get a chance, hit that subscribe button. I would appreciate it. Keep the channel going. All right. God bless you. Bye.